March 13th, 2018, I suffered a paralysis of my left side of my face. That's why you see the mouth going down. My eye does not blink, and so I've got a real dry eye, and I'm hopefully going to be able to fix that up because it affects my vision just a little bit. I will update this intro to my videos when things start improving, and they will, I'm sure. At least it wasn't a stroke. Remember that I have DVDs, instructional DVDs on how to sculpt and how to buy them and all that at the end of the video. So please, please take a look at that. All right, let's get started with today's video. And I'm sorry I had to take this time, but I figured you might wonder, why is that guy talking so funny? All right, let's get started. Well, I went back through the pictures of the lady that I'm sculpting, and I found one of her hand and arm, which is helpful to show me the kind of, hand and arm she has. And I found this of the strap that goes across her chest. Most of the pictures hide this, and because of the position of her arms, and since she's not actually posing for this thing, I figured that gives me a good idea where the strap is connected to on her chest, and I wasn't too far off on that. So anyway, and then also her hat, I'm going to cover her face a little bit, is this style hat she's wearing in on the sculpture, and I can see how the head strap is, so I've got to work on that too. But right now I'm going to work on her hand, and let's get started on that. That intro is for new people coming in, or people who haven't seen me for a while and wonder why I'm talking funny. After you see it once, I don't see any reason why you'd have to see it twice or more. Just go right directly to 1 minute and 7 seconds into the video, and you'll see the starting of this part of the video, which is the sculpting part. And so I just wanted to let you know that, because I don't want to bore the crap out of anybody. All right, I'm going to get back to work. I'm just going to assume that the buckle is going to be down here too for the belly strap. And so I'm going to move that to the front, because I'm sure she'd want to have it where she can get it done easily without reaching around. Pardon the strange noises in the back. That's my heater, my propane heater, letting me know that it's starting up. Thank God for that. I'm going to put it in line with the strap above and have it come down in front of her pants here. I don't have an actual picture showing where it's at, and so I'm just guessing here. Well, it's not a bad guess. Okay. And the strap and beginning of the buckle. The way I say buckle reminds me of a movie with Red Skelton that I saw. It was from the 1940s. And he was a Civil War spy for the North, down South. And he had to remember that the note was in the buckle with the belt, or the boot with the belt with the buckle, or something like that. And he, for some reason, had a hard time saying it, and I can't remember why. It's a great movie. I wish I knew what the name of it was. It was a funny movie, man. I was so lucky to get to meet Red Skelton before he died at Caesars in Tahoe. I was sculpting or demonstrating there, and he came over and talked to me for a while, which was what a privilege to get to meet that man. I feel sorry for you young kids who don't know who the heck he is, because he's probably one of the greatest comedians that ever lived. Well, anyway, back to work. What I'm using is Ronsonol, a lighter fluid, and I'm going to probably go over it a couple more times before I take it to the foundry, because it's got to dry, and then I got to see where the imperfections are, because this will show up the imperfections in the clay, and I will take care of those over time. It'll take probably another couple hours of just letting it dry, evaporate. It doesn't actually dry with it. What the Ronsonol does, it just evaporates off the clay. It also does the same thing with wax. For some reason, there's something in this liquid that slightly melts. The wax of that you're using, as well as clay. So it's a real handy thing. I used to get this one liquid that had the smell of oranges, and I think a lot of jewelers use it. I got it from Rio Grande, which is a jeweler supply place in Arizona, And they had a product that you could do this with, and it was even better than this, but it left an oiliness to the clay, and it made it almost difficult or almost impossible for the foundry to make a mold of the clay. So if you ever work with a foundry, ask them what is best for doing this, because not everything that you use is going to work with the foundry. All right, that's going to be it for tonight, and I'll pick this up tomorrow when I photograph it and get this to the foundry on Monday or Tuesday. I got a doctor's appointment on Wednesday, and a therapist appointment on Wednesday as well. So good night, everybody. Been nice having you along. Things aren't so lonely with you guys around. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.